Is it safe to use free images or video clips?
This is a dangerous question.
So this is something that, number one, this is not legal advice.
Not at all.
This is not legal advice. But I think both David and I can give some context from a business perspective.
Because of experience.
Because of experience. There is a great video that we'll link in the description by Tom Scott, who talks about YouTube copyright and how the YouTube copyright system isn't broken, but the actual copyright laws are broken. That has a great deal to do with this topic. I strongly encourage you, once you're done watching our videos, which could take you a while because we have lots, so watch them all first. But go watch Tom Scott's video on copyright. The nature of royalty-free images online has changed in the last few years. In 2006, when YouTube started using royalty-free stuff, there really wasn't anybody watching. And so you could get away with it. And as the years have progressed, more and more businesses exist to protect copyright, both for creators and for corporations.
There are people who profit on it, not just protect.
Yeah, and that's kind of why I was hesitating, because profiting is a big part of it. Copyright is a real thing, and just because an image appears in a royalty-free library online, that doesn't mean, A, that the image was ever supposed to be there. It doesn't mean, B, that the creator of that image can choose to move it into a copyrighted place. And C, doesn't mean that you're guaranteed to be legally indemnified should something change with copyright. So be very careful. That's the real end of the question.
Yeah.
Be very careful. Buy from legitimate, recognized agencies, 123RF, iStock Photo,
Epidemic Getty Images, for sounds.
Epidemic for audio, or
Artlist.io.
Use video blocks or things like that that have from organizations.
Even the YouTube library.
Especially the YouTube library. But from creative sources that provide a written license when you make your downloads. Something that gives you some leg to stand on if somebody comes after you.
Or alternatively, if in your account of said system, they don't give you a license because it's implied in their notes, what we do is we save that information, as well as we screen capture our download history on the platform. Because we have had many situations, very unpleasant, where you get these cease and desist and you owe us all these thousands of dollars of money because you're doing copyright infringement on this image, and we legitimately got it from a platform. But what if you didn't renew that account? Let's say it was 5 years ago or 4 years ago, and you don't have access to the download history or the license keys anymore. You'd want proof. Number two, we've seen acquisitions where, I'm not going to name any company names, but some of these big stock images companies go and acquire the sub ones, take over their content, and don't honor or recognize the licenses that people obtained them from this platform and not directly from their platform. Very bad situations if you can't prove, because honestly, it's guilty until proven innocent. That is literally the system.
And the key to that statement, proven innocent, means that you're gonna go to court and you're gonna stand in front of a judge. So you're gonna spend the time and money to defend yourself, even if you're genuinely, legitimately using something. It's not to be trifled with. Using images found online, bad idea. Buy them,
get a license.
Or video clips
or sound,
anything else.
Audio.
Again, watch Tom Scott's video on copyright and how the copyright system is broken. It'll make much more sense. It's a big topic. We urge our clients every day, read the contracts. You can't just go to Canva and use their image library for other things unless the license that you have specifically allows you to do it. Read the licenses, look at your usage, make sure they apply.
And whether you can profit off of it for the duration of the license.
Or the duration of the piece.
Whether you have to register it. We use Epidemic for our audio files, for background music tracks, and all of our YouTube videos. We have to actually individually register every one of those. If a client goes and posts a video that we edit on their channel, we have to tell them that it is part of our license. It's okay. Otherwise, YouTube comes and it does a quick copyright infringement on it.
Yeah. You get flagged. Yeah. So, yes, it is possible to use media from a third party, but be careful.
Be careful.
Be careful. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching.
We had to get one of those in. Thanks for watching. If you like what you see on the channel, click the subscribe button down below. And if you'd like to be notified of upcoming episodes, hit the little bell. Ding, ding, ding. That's where the editor should have put dings.